Hi, and welcome to this guide on how to use your Mac. It's intended for people who are brand new to Mac from Windows, but if you've never owned Windows and have a Mac, that's okay too. So this is basically how to get to grips with your Mac really quickly. It's meant to be a really useful guide on how to do that because I went through the experience. There are a couple of things I needed to know quickly, so this guide should hopefully cover those. Let's start off with moving around, okay? So yeah, you'll either be using a mouse or a trackpad. It depends what you've got. So we're going to look at that first, because if you can't move around properly, you won't be able to do anything. Makes sense, right? Okay. So this is System Preferences. We go in there, it covers most of your settings. If you got a mouse, you click on this. I'm using a trackpad, so it's not going to come up. If you did get a mouse, you have to turn it on from the bottom. There's a switch you flick up. If you get a wireless mouse, if it's not wireless, then plug it in to your USB and you're good to go. But for a Bluetooth mouse, you will have to sync that. But you know, as soon as you go in, it will start looking for it. Make sure your Bluetooth is on by going in here, okay? So it is on for me. And it's discovered that I used to have a mouse, but it's not plugged in now, which is correct. So let's go into trackpad and show you what we can do here. So this shows you some of the things you could do. Right now it's showing me that if I go and use two fingers up and down, I can scroll, and it shows me up here what exactly that looks like. So that's good if I have it enabled, but if I want to disable that, I can just take it. So have a look and see, like, this is quite familiar, the zoom in or out. I think a lot of people know this, right? Zooming in and zooming out from your tablets or your smartphones. So that's the same thing. Really useful feature, turning it on. If you don't like it, you can turn it off. Other gestures as well. As you can see, most of these I've got ticked because I do use most of them myself, okay? But you can change the behavior. So for example, if you want to change how you swipe between full screen apps, you can change here. There's some other options available to you, okay? So that's really good to go. Have a mess around with that, and then your trackpad will be configured just the way you like it. Let's have a look up here first before I close this. X is on this side, okay? Closing Windows. On Windows, it would be normally here, but it's on the right-hand side, okay? And this is in a small line, is a minimize button, so there's nothing really too complicated about that. Now, have you got the right Mac? Is this the one that you wanted to buy? Let's take a look. This is a really useful icon. It's the Apple icon. You go to the first one, about this Mac. So this is telling me I do have a 3.5 gigahertz i7. That's the processor I've got. This is telling me I've got 24 gig of memory. And I'm on the Mac system. I'm on Mavericks, which is 10.9. And before that was Mountain Lion, which is 10.8. And before that was Snow Leopard and a few others. But the 0.9 part tells me that it's Mavericks. There's quite a few of them that were 10 point something. So you can upgrade from 10.6 onwards through the Mac App Store. Now, speaking of which, do I need to do any software updates? This will take me immediately to the Mac App Store, which I can also find down here. And in fact, I didn't even need to open that. It's telling me that I need to update one software. So Smart Converter, I can update that. If I press that, it'll ask me for my username and my password. Here's purchases I've already made. Here's the categories. Top charts, this will be familiar to you if you have a tabloid or a browser and you go through your own app store. Let's see all the free stuff I can get because I'm cheap. Lovely. You just press it and install it. Look here. This one says installed because I've already got it. This one says free because I don't have it, but I have the option of installing it. That featured shows you probably some really useful apps that you could go for. Okay. Now look at this one here you haven't seen before. If I press this, it should maximize the screen to the full settings of that application. So this application, it doesn't make it full screen, it doesn't fill your screen. It fills it as much as is needed for that particular product, okay? So for example, this is the Mac Store. For us to view all contents of the Mac Store, then we press this. To go back to the view we had, we press it again. To minimize it, we press that, of course. And to close it, we press that. a better example of what I just showed you is if I go into Safari, which is like our version of Internet Explorer. And if I was to press the plus sign now, it makes it small and it makes it big because that's all the space I need to see everything. But I can also press this beside it, which will maximize the window. So that's how you maximize the window. Problem is, there's no buttons now anymore. They're all gone. So all you do is scroll up to the top and you press this blue one, and that will minimize it for you again. Well, it will shrink it down. It won't minimize it. I press this and then it gets minimized. And you see that it went down here? And you see this line here? This tells you anything beyond this line is something you've minimized. And anything to the left of that line are apps that you can quickly go into. Another way to get your apps are by going to this button here, which is called Spotlight. So if I want to open up a program called Pages, I type it in and hit enter. And now I can go into Pages, and that's like my Word document. Any Mac that you buy from the 22nd of October 2013 onward, you should get iWork, which is Pages, Numbers, and Keynotes, which is Apple's version of Microsoft Office. You should get that for free. If you don't have it already installed, you need to type in up-to-date program iWorks, and you should be able to find a link for it, okay? So, let's go back into this, okay? We went into software update, and we got a bit distracted there. Let's press more info. This will tell you really what you're getting inside your computer. So, now I can see I have a processor and memory, but I also have a graphics card. So I know now what type of graphics card I have. I know now if I have additional RAM. So I've got 4 GB of RAM on this. This is really useful if you're talking to tech support. Always go in here, and then press more info, and that will show them the serial number, which will quickly bring up all of this information. Now for me, the memory on my iMac actually wasn't 24 GB. If I go to memory, I can show you that I actually got 8 GB, so they put in 2 4 gigs. So, you know, that's okay. That doesn't really matter to Apple if you've upgraded your memory. You know, they don't really care about that. It's important to know that certain Macs you can upgrade the memory on a lot easier than others. So I got the 27 inch iMac, which has slots in the back that allow you to upgrade. So here you can see I've put in myself 2 8 gig slots, and that's what gives me my 24 gig memory overall, okay? So 8 gig is the maximum you can have in a slot. If you want to know your own specifications or the type of memory you can get, press that button, the memories upgrades instructions. It's really useful and it takes you to the link. Find out your Mac. I'm going to go and press my one, which is late 2013. And this tells me the type of RAM I can go and upgrade. It must meet these specifications. If you want to get it cheaper, surf it online, of course. Crucial is a really good company. Crucial RAM, C-R-U-C-I-A-L. I used them before. And you might find cheaper RAM, but some RAMs are incompatible because of their timings and voltages, and that's not covered here, you see. It doesn't mention timings or voltages. Crucial is what I recommend. There are a lot of good guides on how to install memory effectively as well. So, we've covered memory as well. We covered the overview. The display tells you your resolution as well. And this is really useful. The storage tells you how much you have free. So I have a hard drive inside with 784 GB of free information. If I scroll down, you can see what I've got plugged in. I've got a SD card plugged in, and I've also got a drive which I'm using as a time machine, which means that I can go and restore it to a backup state. This is support as well, so if you want to get information, you can press these. If you want help from Apple, you can go and check all of that here, okay? So, and it gives me the options I have. So this is a really useful thing. If you go to selfsolved.apple.com and you type in your serial number, this is what it'll look like. It'll tell you exactly what you have, the product that you have. And it'll tell you exactly, you know, the year and the launch time. So this is late 2013. 13, and it'll even tell you if you're still covered. So I know that I'm still covered on my product, which is great, and I expect to be because I only bought it about a month or so ago. If you want to move around on your Mac, then go into Finder. That's like your Windows version. A quick tip is to press the Command button, which is beside your Space button on the left and right, okay? So press Command, the Shift button, and H. And that takes you to your home screen, which is really useful. Over here, you have Downloads, Movies, Music, and Pictures. You're probably used to that from Windows, Desktop as well. So I just added two more folders, Torrents, Windows Torrents. So I know that I can find them at the top level. Another way of getting places is by pressing Go. So if I press Go on Desktop, I start to go to the desktop and see everything I've got there. But if I press on Home, you can see there's the shortcuts. So you can press these on your Mac and go there. And very quickly, you're at the top end level, okay? So if I go into my Documents, I can press the back button here, and that'll take me one level back, okay? These are all the things I've got booted or plugged into the back of my computer. I've got the SD card in there. I've got the 1 terabyte hard drive. Programs also will appear here. So sometimes you have to eject a program. Like for example, I've got Adobe Flash. I can eject that, but that's not something I want to do because I do want Adobe Flash running in the background. So I'll close that off, okay? One important thing about Finder. Oh, by the way, let's have a look at this picture. Yeah, let's do that. So if I double click the picture, it brings it up here in preview. So as you can see here, for most things, you'll be using the command option. In Windows, you would normally use the control option. But for the Mac, you use the command option, which has that sign on it, which kind of looks like a square with circular corners, okay? So for me to go home, then I need to press Control Shift, which may or may not have a top arrow symbol on it, and H, okay? Now, if I want to screenshot this page, that's really useful, the print screen option. I press Command, Shift, and 3. That does a screenshot of the page, and listen out for a click. If I want to screenshot something more specific at a certain area, press Command, Shift, and 4, and this comes up. So now I can just screenshot this eye. When I let go, it appears on the desktop, and I can double click that. So that's great and really useful to know. Look over here. This is Finder that I'm in right now. I know what program I'm in because beside the Mac, look for this, and it's in bold writing compared to the others, which are functions of the program. So the program is Finder. If I go to Messages, the program is Messages, and the menu is for that program, okay? So if you want to do something on Finder and you can't, it's because you're not actually in Finder. So press Finder, and then you'll be able to use its services, okay? So for example, if I'm in Pages, right, it's already open, and I want to save this. Whoa, there's no drop down menus here. What's going on? Well, it's all up here, so I can go to File, Save. That's automatically saved because I've already saved this file once. It didn't give me the option to save as. Look at this screenshot I did. One of the great things about the Macs is you can just drop it in there. There's no text box, there's nothing to fiddle around with. You know, so you just move it up and down. You can increase the size, reduce the size, carry on writing underneath it. Look at that, beautiful. So that's a really nice feature of having a Mac. If you want to look for something, let's look for roses. Okay, that's a nice picture of a rose. I'll just take that, and there it is. That's how easy it is to save a picture, okay? Let's say I wanted to download it. I would right click and press Save Image Downloads. Now, did you see that bump? What that shows you is stuff that you've downloaded. It goes into your download folder, okay? Here's some of the recent things I've downloaded. If there's more, you know, I can press the down arrow. If I want to be specific, I can press this. It takes me to the downloaded folder. that I have, okay? So if you want to download something like an image or a PDF document, you just right click and you go to save image to downloads, okay? That will do that. Or you can just drag it across down here. Another thing we might want to do is set up our mail. When you open your mail, if this isn't there, that means your mail isn't configured. So all you have to do is go into mail. I know I'm in mail because it's highlighted, and press add account. When I press add account, it gives me the option of the most common ones. If you want Hotmail, you're going to press this one and press continue. Type in your email address at Hotmail or at Live, whatever it is, and your password, and it will start to configure it. If you've noticed, once this is done, you don't have any new mail. That's pretty straightforward. You just go to mailbox, get new mail, and that will start seeing if you've got any new mail, and it will download that as well. If I did have new mail, once you do this, everything will come up here in the notifications tab. Okay, so that's a quick way of getting set up. A great site to go to for downloading things on your Mac is CNET, okay? So if you go to cnet.com, press download. Actually, look, there it is, download Mac software, okay? Okay, or you can just press the Mac tab. Here are some free downloads, okay? Which is great. Now, some of these are free, some of them are trials. The majority of them will be free though, but you can find out if something is a trial or not by clicking on it. Now, these files are in a format called DMG, okay? I don't know what DMG stands for, but to be honest, I don't need to know. I just know that that's the format that they're in. I'm going to show you an example of how that works. So I got most of these programs already installed. You don't need all of them. Yeah, I've heard this is good. So let's have a look at GIMP. Okay, nice, good ratings. I can see a video of it here if I want to as well, but I'm just going to go and download it. So I'm going to press this here. Make sure you're very careful where you press the download button. This is an advert for Norton, but it has a download button. You might see other download, you know, options. This one is actually for the product. So I press this, and now it started downloading it. Now I can see from the progress bar how long it will take. I can press this as well and see progress in there. So it has started downloading it. Okay, so the download has been completed. So I'm going to show you now how to install something from the internet. Now, I use CNET because I trust that. So always choose places that you trust. So now it will come up with this hard drive icon. But the most important thing to look out for is that it says DMG. Now, if I press DMG, it will start to open. So here it is. It's opened. You can read this. It's not installed yet. It's just kind of been extracted. So, well, these are actually notes. But if I press this, then it will start, you know, to install the program. So it's saying to me is, you know, do you really want to trust this? And I'm going to say yes. And once I do that, it will be installing the program for me. Okay, so that's it. Easy as that. Sometimes when you install something, you may have to drag the icon into the applications folder. So you go into Finder, go into Applications. If I press G, GIMP isn't there. So it actually works when you double click on it. But other things, like for example, Handbrake. Once you've installed Handbrake, then you have to drag the icon of Handbrake into the applications folder, okay? So if you ever see anything with the icon and an arrow to a folder, you can actually press the icon of the application and move it into the folder, okay? If that doesn't make sense, YouTube it and look for another guide more specific, but that's how you install something onto your computer. The final thing I want to show you before I go is to do with pictures. So if you want to preview lots of pictures, here's what you do, okay? If find your pictures. And now look, if I just open one, one is opened, okay? Now I can't do anything here. It's just opening one picture. I want to see more. Left, right, I can't do it. That's frustrating. So what you have to do is go into Finder, press Command A, which highlights everything, and then press space. When you press space, then you go and maximize the picture, and there you go. You have left and right arrows, and you can go through all your lovely pictures, okay? Another thing you can do is you can press the I button, okay? After you've done that. So again, do the same thing, maximize it, and move left and right. Okay, now if you don't have the I button, here's how you get it. Go here and right click to customize toolbar, and then you can go and drag this into the gray area here. If you want to know if your printer is installed, just go into printers and scanners from settings. It will tell you if it is, and in my case it has been, and it's wireless. I didn't have to do anything, it just found it automatically. But you can also go to your page of your printer, which you'll find at the back of your printer. You can find the name of your printer, the model number, and type in the word Mac, and you can download the drivers for it. That concludes my guide to the Mac. Thanks for watching, and I hope that helps you out in getting started. Once you get to know the basics, you'll really pick things up, but I'll include more tutorials later. Thanks for watching. Take care.